Hello everyone, welcome to Unite Coaching. In the last video, we have seen the estimation of quantity of concrete for lift in Microsoft Excel. In this video, we will learn the estimation of quantity of concrete required for columns. If you have not watched our previous videos, please watch those videos first. Now, let's start with the tutorial. As you can see here, the columns are divided in the same group as footing. The first group of columns has 15 columns in it, whose size is 230 mm by 300 mm. So I have entered the number as 15 and the size as 0.23 meter by 0.3 meter. Now the height of column. The height of bottom story is 2.7 meter and the footing is 2 meter below the ground level. So the columns will be 2 meter below the ground level. So the total height of column from the footing top to the parking slab will be 2.7 meter plus 2 meter. That will be equal to 4.7 meter. For your better understanding, I am showing you the section of column from footing to the top story in the AutoCAD. As you can see here, the bottom story is 3.7 meter. And the foundation is taken 2 meter below the ground level. So the total height will be 4.7 meter for our calculation, which can be entered in Excel in the height column. Similarly, the other stories are of 3 meter height. That is, the first steel floor, the second steel floor, and the third steel floor are of 3 meter height. The last part remaining in the calculation is quantity. And it will be calculated by just multiplying number, length, width and height. So the formula in Excel will be is equal to cell C23 multiplied by cell D23 multiplied by cell E23 and multiplied by cell F23, which comes as 4.86 cubic meter. Similarly, the quantity of concrete for all other column groups will be calculated. We have to just enter the number and size there because the height is constant, which is 4.7 meter. So for our calculation, just drag the cursor downwards and Excel will calculate the quantity. Similarly, I have just copy pasted the above groups and changed the value of height of floor from 4.7 meter to 3 meter as all the above floors are of 3 meter height. So just copy paste the above items as our size and number of columns in a group are same. You will just have to change the value of height from 4.7 meter to 3 meter in Excel. In this way, you can calculate the quantity of concrete required for footing for columns from footing top to the third floor in Excel. But the quantity of concrete for all the columns is not completed yet. In the plan, as you can see here, there will be 4 columns for supporting the headroom slab. So those columns will be taken separately and those columns are column C21, C22, C32 and C3. The size of these columns is 230 mm by 230 mm. So I have entered the length and width as 0.23 meter by 0.23 meter. There are 4 columns in this group, so the number will be 4 in Excel. The height of headroom column is 2.6 meter. So I have entered the value as 2.6 meter in the height column. Now calculate the quantity. Now the quantity will be calculated similarly as we have calculated previously. The same group of columns are extended up to water tank. So I just copy pasted this and changed the value of height only. The height for headroom was 2.6 meter. So change this value of 2.6 meter to 2 meter as the height of columns for the water tank is 2 meter. The last part is to add up the total quantity of concrete for the columns for all the floors. So put the formula in Excel as is equal to in bracket cell G23 is to cell G52, which comes to be 35.67 cubic meter. In this way, you can calculate the quantity of concrete required for columns. In the next video, we will start with the calculation of quantity of concrete for lift shear wall in Excel. Thanks for watching this video. If you have any doubt regarding this video, please comment in the comment section below. Thanks for watching.